Thing right. Hello to all my wonderful friends. Want to make sure you're all hearing me. And in fact, if you don't mind, I'm going to have a wonderful time with you today teaching on the power and gentleness of the Holy Spirit. I just want to make sure you can all hear me. So please send me an email quickly to Benny Hinn, Pastor Benny at BennyHinn.org. That's just Pastor Ben at BennyHinn.org. I want to just make sure you can all hear me before I begin teaching. And get ready. It's going to be wonderful today. Anyways, that's Pastor Benny at BennyHinn.org. Just let me know you can hear me. I have my email on. And just send me an email that says, yeah, I can hear you. That's all I need. In fact, you know what? You've got the comments, right? Okay, just send me a quick comment on Facebook and let me know you can hear me. And then dear Tim will give me the go ahead. So can you all hear me, you sweet people? Just want to make sure, because I'm not getting any emails at this point. All right.
Periscope, they say they can hear you. No one's commenting on Facebook yet. They're saying amen.
All right. Just want to make sure those on Periscope can hear me. All right. There we go. Loud and clear. Beautiful. And also on Facebook. Can they hear me on Facebook? Because I just got...
Yes, sir, I can.
Okay, great. Well, anyways, one more time, hello to all my wonderful friends. And I want to just put my phone on plane mode so nobody would call me while I'm teaching. I am going to have a fabulous time with you today. I love talking about the Holy Spirit. You know, He changed my life. He's all I have. He's all you have on this earth. We say Jesus is in my heart, but you know what we mean, right? It's the Holy Spirit. It's His Holy Spirit. Let's pray. Wonderful Lord Jesus, we come today in absolute trust in You, in absolute faith, Lord, that You touch our hearts and lives today and quicken us. Move mightily in our lives. We love You with all our hearts. We bless Your precious holy name. Wonderful Savior. And God's people said amen and amen. And by the way, many of you have sent an email asking when we start with Partner Connect. This week we start. Isn't that fantastic? So all of you pastors, all of you partners, we'll be sending you a message on email. Those that have sent us an email will get an announcement from us on when you can register. And finally, it's this week. You know, our staff has been working very hard at building the new app that's required to make this work, where you and I can have Bible studies and so much. I want to mentor you, bless you, minister to you. But I want you to know the first subject I want to deal with the pastors is on leadership in ministry. And it'll be powerful, I promise you. I'm going to show you how to prepare messages, how to find the right material, how to present that to the people, and so much more. All valuable information that I believe the Lord's going to really bless you with. And then for the partners, I want to minister on preparation for ministry. This is a very powerful teaching I have for you in the things God will show you and train you in to make you useful for His wonderful kingdom. So this all begins this week, and all of you that want to be a part of Partner Connect or Pastor Connect, please write me. Now remember the email addresses. The ones for Partner Connect is partnerconnect@benihin.org. The one for Pastor Connect is pastorconnect@benihin.org. All other emails you can send to Pastor Benny at BennyHinn.org. Now, let's talk about the Holy Spirit. Holy wind, holy breath, Ruach, Ruach HaKodesh, holy breath. He's a person. Now, think about your breath. that when you breathe, you release only what's in your lungs and then you stop. Not so with God. He is eternal breath. Think about breath that is eternal, unstoppable breath. So when God breathed into Adam's nostril the breath of life, that breath is still being released because it's eternal. The breath of God has no end. Mine and yours does. We breathe, and then we have to inhale and exhale, right? The Holy Spirit is the continual exhale of heaven. Ha ha! He's the continual breath of God. There is no inhale with him. There's only... And when he releases his breath, which is ongoing, eternal, it depends on the position and the condition of the believer, what he will experience. Some will experience a mighty wind. Some will experience a gentle breeze, depending on where they are. Sometimes the breath of God is so mighty, all at the same time, so gentle to the person right next door to you. He doesn't allow us to experience his breath the same. We all experience the breath differently. There are times the breath comes to remove the chaff. There are times the breath comes to bring peace. Times the breath comes to bring healing, resurrection, life, and so on. The breath of God, we experience it dependent on where we stand with him. For a whole year in 1974, I experienced his breath with might that removed the chaff out of my life. When there is much chaff, God has to remove it very quickly. It's a quick work, says the Lord. I'll do a quick work. Well, when God does a quick work, it demands, it requires his breath to be stronger. You know, like people, you know, sometimes you see these people blowing leaves away, you know, and they have to put it on high to get all the garbage out. Well, God releases that mighty breath to remove the chaff. A mighty wind came on the day of Pentecost. But why the mighty wind? Why wasn't the wind gentle in the upper room? To transform them. To remove everything old and make it new. I love it. It took, Tim is really enjoying it back there. He's holding the phones, really enjoying it. Well, Tim, I'm telling you this the same. Sometimes, well, think. Minutes prior, they were all afraid. It was his power that removed the fear. It was his power that brought boldness in a second. That mighty wind is so effective to remove the flesh out of the way, to remove the filth out of the way, to remove fear out of the way, and everything else that is piled up in life that means nothing really to the Spirit of God. The Holy Ghost will just... Remember what it says about the Lord? He will destroy by the breath of his mouth. Oh, he'll destroy the wicked by the breath of his mouth. Whenever, now you hear me good, okay? Whenever the breath is strong, it contains fire. That's why the fire came on their heads. Because strong breath always produces fire. Manta kolal pepi alba kanti. Aren't you loving it, Tim?
It's good.
Yeah, it's good. Of course it's good. It's the Holy Spirit is so mighty. He's a gentle breeze and he's a mighty wind. But he's more than that. He's a life-giving wind. He's not just mighty and gentle. He's life-giving. And that blessed breath of God. God breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. Whoa, wow. It brings life. You know, when God breathed into Adam, three things happened. His spirit was created. A new spirit came into him. His soul was released at the same time, same instant. The personality was formed. You know what amazes me? Is how different all my grandchildren are from each other. They all have their own unique personality. None is the same. Not one is the same as the other. There's no such thing as a perfect copy, you know? Every snowflake is different. Every fingerprint is different. That's the creativity of the Holy Spirit. So when he breathed into his nostril, Adam became a unique living soul, none like him. No other copy like him. The breath of God gives you personality, your own personality. Adam's own personality was given to him right there. God creates his spirit, gives him personality, gives him intellect, gives him emotion that is wrapped in that breath. That's why it says only the word can divide both. The breath of God in the spirit of man is mingled, the soul. You cannot separate them. There's no way you can do it medically. It's impossible. Only God's blessed power can do that. That's why the spirit and the soul are eternal, because they are so much one. It's like, oh my goodness, if I take a glass of water, and I have one over there, but I think you'll get this. If I take this bottle and another bottle and I put half and half in a glass, you cannot separate the water, can you? Same thing. Think about this. The spirit and the soul are one cup and one cup put together. Water and water coming together. Well, you can't separate that, can you? Impossible. But God can. Only the word of God, it says, can. So when it says the spirit and soul are united, it's not like hand in hand. It's not like, you know, it's water and water. Impossible to separate. But the Holy Spirit can separate both, like I said. So when God breathed, there was spirit, there was soul, but there was also what? Blood. Now that's powerful. Because the Bible says the spirit, the word, and the blood are in agreement. That's in the epistle of John. It means the blood flowed through his body. Therefore, every time I say the blood of Jesus, the spirit and the word are right there. The spirit of God and the word, which is also water. Don't forget that. That spirit and the word, the scripture says he will wash us with water. We are cleansed. Fresh blood and fresh water. The blood of Jesus is always fresh blood. I love it. And the reason I say it is because blood dies, you know, but not his blood. Our blood dies. The second our blood, there's death, it actually gets rotten. But the blood of Jesus is pure, precious, and living. It's alive. There's a fountain filled with blood. It's living. It's a living fountain. Well, the Holy Spirit, who is the breath of God, is also water, is also fire. But his breath released, and I know that, you know, I don't want to go too deep with you. I don't want to lose you here, okay? But when he breathed into Adam's nostril, at that moment, what? His spirit and soul came together. And he became a living soul, a personality, a living spirit, one that can express himself. And the blood flow to give his body life, because life is in the blood, remember that. Now, the Holy Spirit, when you and I were born again, the Holy Spirit came into our spirit man and united himself to our spirit man. So we are no longer separated from the Holy Spirit. He that is joined to the Lord, the Bible says, is one spirit in Corinthians. We're not two, we're one. And the Lord said, he said, I in them, they in me. Just like water again, okay? Just keep that example in your mind. Two cups of water becoming one cup of water. I in them, they in me, that they may be made perfect in one. And then the world will know. The world will believe. How? Because now there's power. There's power coming out of that life. Without the Holy Spirit, there is no power. Jesus is not revealed to the world. So that's why we need him more than ever right now. We need the Holy Spirit in our own life, not only to transform us by his wind, not only to remove all the chaff, all the dirt, all the ungodliness, all the flesh, the old life, gone. But we want the fire too to come with it, to purge and purify a new vessel unto him. Now I'm going to say something here. I don't want you missing. The wind removes and the fire constructs in the Bible. Whenever the fire of God comes on the believer, there's construction, not destruction. The fire of God does two things. To the unbeliever, it destroys. To the believer, it builds. Who shall dwell? Isaiah says, who shall dwell with the everlasting burning, the everlasting fire? It says, he that walks righteously. The fire of God in the life of the believer is building the character, the nature, the image of Jesus. While in the unbeliever, if that fire comes, it destroys them. Can I say this to you without shaking you up? What is heaven to us is Sheol to them. What is light to us is darkness to them. And the word Sheol means hell. What destroys the unbeliever is building me up. The same fire builds and destroys at the same time. God is fire. But to me, he illuminates me. He's building me up. He's revealing Jesus. The fire on the day of Pentecost did what? It didn't burn no one. It didn't destroy any of the 120. That fire empowered them. They became new human beings, new men, new women in Christ Jesus, anointed by the Spirit to go preach the gospel, lay hands on the sick, raise the dead. Fire so powerful, it translated Philip. Fire so powerful, it convicted the eunuch. Fire so powerful, it brought thousands upon thousands into the kingdom of God. Fire so powerful, it gave boldness and wisdom to Stephen. That no one can resist by the words he spoke, just like Jeremiah. He said, I have, it's like fire in his mouth, he said. Fire in his heart, he couldn't contain it. He had to speak it out. It was a fire that brought conviction, fire that brought transformation to those that heard and believed. But when that fire comes on the unbeliever, it destroys them. What is light to us is darkness to them. That's what happened in Egypt. Remember the cloud between the Egyptians and the children of Israel? To one it brought light, and to the other brought darkness. Never forget this. The cloud, oh my. When I look at the cloud, I see brightness. It's a bright cloud to me. To the unbeliever, it's the opposite. It brings destruction. Yeah, we're getting a little deeper than maybe I wanted to go with you. But you look at the Bible, you look at the book of Exodus. Darkness to one group and light to another. When we walk in his presence, we walk in his light. The fire of God brings destruction to the wicked and life to me and you. That's the Holy Spirit. Because he is all at the same time. The spirit of life, oh yes. The spirit of glory, oh yes. He brings to you and I such liberty, such life, such glory, such beauty. But the unbeliever knows not the way of the Spirit. He will never understand the ways of the Spirit, is what the Bible says. He cannot receive the Holy Spirit. Neither does he understand the Scripture, the life of the Word of God. An unbeliever can read and close the book and not know what he read. But I can read and give me life. The Spirit, the words that I speak, they are spirit, they are life, Jesus said. So the Holy Spirit, oh, he is so colorful. He's so exciting, full of life. And wherever he is, there's not only life, there's change, transformation. He transforms the believer. He transforms you and I into the image of the Lord. If there's sickness, that man becomes healthy, the woman becomes healthy, because in his presence is healing power. If there's bondage, the chains fall off when he's there. In the presence of the Lord, where the Holy Spirit is, there is liberty from all bondage. It's impossible to have a devil running around when the Holy Ghost is there. I cannot accept the teaching that says that a true Christian can be demon-possessed. It's impossible. How can he? Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty, liberty, liberty. It's that simple. Now, the soul can be oppressed, absolutely. The soul can be oppressed if the believer is not living properly, righteously, walking with God. The price of neglect is high. If the believer neglects the word of God, he's in serious trouble. And oppression will set in on his soul. You know, it's like this. Think about oil in the lamp, but dirt on the wick. Tim is doing this, he's getting it. Dirt on the wick is oppression. Therefore, the light cannot shine. It's like a lamp. It's like a candle. If the wick is dirty, the candle, there's no light. You cannot light the candle because the wick has dirt. That's the oppression. People must be free from oppression. How? By the renewal of the mind. How? By the word. The word is the cleansing agent of the wick. It removes the dirt of the wick. Wow. Every day in the tabernacle, they put fresh oil. But if the wick was not, was filthy, no light. And it's the word of God that cleanses the wick. You know, in the Old Testament, by the way, those priests were speaking the word the whole time they were in the holy place. People don't realize that. Moses commanded the priesthood what God commanded him. This word is nigh thee in thy mouth. You speak it day and night. You as a priest have to speak the word. So when they walked into the tabernacle, Tim, did you know that? When they walked into the holy place, the word was coming out of them. They were speaking the word the whole time. No priest was allowed to be in the presence of God without the word proceeding out of the mouth. Well, it was the word that cleanses the wick. Well, they were doing it with their hand, of course. But God was showing us something powerful in the spirit. Only the word spoken can cleanse the wick, the mind. Hallelujah. And when you cleanse the mind, the wick, the oil starts working. The light starts shining. The Holy Spirit wants our cooperation, keeping our minds clean for him. That's our part. He will fill us with oil, and that's in the Spirit. That's why I say there can be no pollution in the spirit of man, we are complete in him, it says. The pollution is only in the mind. And it's our duty to cleanse it with the word. And how it says the spirit of your mind. The spirit of your mind means that it's the spoken word, the spiritual power of the spoken word that will actually cleanse it. So when I speak the word, it becomes life-giving. And I'm declaring the promises of God. Look, it's communion with the Lord on a daily basis that keeps the flow of the word coming out of my lips. Where I'm praising him, I'm thanking him, I'm exalting his holy name, crying out, you are holy, you are worthy. I praise your name, Jesus. I bless your holy name, Jesus. You are my rock. You are my fortress. You are my deliverer. It's fellowship that brings that about. And when I do that, the Holy Ghost begins to use that word to cleanse the wick of my heart and mind. And I start praising him, but I begin to bless his name, wonderful Jesus. My darling Jesus, wonderful, precious Savior. You are the, and I keep going. You are the source of my strength. You are the light of my life. You are the rock. And I just keep going, blessing him like this. I do it, dear God. It's awesome. When I begin to praise him like this and tell him who he is in my life, I'm not just saying it from my mind. Now it's coming out of my heart. My being starts to praise him. My fortress, my rock, my deliverer. You're all in all to me, Lord. And I begin to praise him. You're exalted. You're the Son of the living God. Seated at God's right hand, full of authority and power, glory and majesty. Wonderful Jesus. The Holy Spirit comes. Listen, I feel the anointing just now talking. It's the Holy Spirit is released to cleanse my mind. Whatsoever things are beautiful, whatsoever things are lovely, I'm now able to express it because I'm speaking it out of my heart and my mind is being cleansed and I'm beginning to exalt him. And my words become more glorious as I go on praising him. Because it's the Holy Spirit that is declaring who he is. No man can say Jesus is Lord without the Holy Ghost saying it through you. But you begin to declare who he is in your life. Who he is to you. How much you adore and love him. You know, he's not just dear Jesus. He's darling Jesus. He's precious Jesus. He's most wonderful Jesus. You run out of words. Because he's beyond, much more than you can ever express. And the Holy Spirit comes in. And the praise begins and the exaltation begins, declaring who he is. And next you know, the Holy Spirit is just cleansing you. And that's what I believe releases that gentle breeze. Because the gentle breeze builds. The mighty wind removes. The gentle breeze builds, constructs, empowers my life. He came as a mighty wind on the day of Pentecost to transform them. To make them into holy, powerful, bold men and women. To remove the old and bring in the new. But the gentle breeze builds. The gentle breeze constructs the image of Christ. Oh, honor the glory of the Lord. Elijah experienced that still, small voice. You know, I've always believed that God had to send the earthquake and the fire and so on to remove all that out of Elijah. There was things in Elijah God wanted to remove. that he could hear his voice when God spoke. What doest thou here? Well, what did he was afraid. He said, I'm the only one left. They're going to kill me now. The Lord had to remove all that to put brand fresh boldness in him to go back to where he came from, where he ran from. He went back to where he ran from to anoint Jehu and the king of Syria and Elisha in his stead. And all of them were actually mighty warriors. A warring spirit came on him at that moment. You got to realize, after he called fire from heaven, he was so discouraged and ran for his life. What would cause a man like Elijah to call fire from heaven one day and destroy the prophets of Baal, and the next day he's running away from one woman who said, I'm going to kill you? Human nature. Something happened. God said, you know, I can't use that man again till that something comes out of him. I got to change him. I got to touch him again. Sends him down to Horeb. Can't have his helper with him. Gehazi you call him. I call him Gehazi. Then he had to leave him in the Negev because he was already flawed. He's the same man that went after Naaman when he worked for Elisha. He was already flawed. He couldn't be there in the presence of God, who wanted Elijah by himself. I know this is some new stuff. You read your Bible. It's all there. God wanted Elijah by himself. So he can change him in that, transform him again. Send him back with a new anointing. And he needed a new anointing. But first he had to get everything out. That's why the earthquake came and the fire came and so on. And when all that happened, God spoke. It was that still small voice that constructed everything in him. So now go back. Anoint Jehu. Anoint Hazael. Anoint Elijah. And so he went back with a new assignment on his heart. The Holy Spirit has to remove before with a mighty wind, before he can build with that gentle breath. God Almighty is about to visit some of you with a mighty wind and some of you with a gentle breath. I've just gone through my mighty wind, okay? The Lord just shook it all out. Thank you, Jesus. Mwah! Now there's been such gentleness. Oh, when I speak his name, I just start to cry. I absolutely, you know, in the meetings, Bob Rogers came to me a few days ago. He said, there's something on you, Benny, and I love it. He said, I've always loved you, always respected the anointing on you. He said, but there's something on you now that I really, really like. He said, it's different. Well, I didn't know what to tell him. I just said, thank you. Thy gentleness hath made me great, David said. The gentleness of the Holy Spirit will make you a new man. You see, the old stuff goes when the wind is forceful. But your gentleness, Lord, is what builds me back up again. I see the gentle, merciful, precious Jesus all over again. No, nobody can be built again seeing the wrath of the Lord. That destroys. You see his gentleness. I've said a lot today, I know. But read your Bible. It's all in there. The change happens after the mighty wind. And the build-up happens after the gentleness. I pray he will visit you with his gentleness now. It's time for his gentleness to come and restore. His gentleness come and rebuild. I will restore to you the years the locust had eaten. Isn't it true? The flood destroys, but the gentle rain builds up. Hurricanes come and destroy. Storms come and destroy. But when that gentle rain comes upon the desert and the land, it just starts to build things up again. God is about to send his gentle wind. I'm going to believe that with you right now. And I'm going to continue tomorrow because there's so much. And tomorrow, I'll continue from class tomorrow night. I want to minister. I want to continue ministering on the power, the mighty, mighty power of the Holy Spirit. Don't miss tomorrow night. You remember last Monday was so strong here? It's going to be a lot stronger today, tomorrow. It's already stronger just here. I'm just by me talking, I'm sensing that anointing, and I know you're receiving it. But I want to deal with a lot more tomorrow on the Holy Spirit. You know, I've talked about his person, how I met him, changed my life. I've never dealt with what I talked about today. And there's a lot more. There's a lot more about him. And I want to share it with you now. Remember. This week we start. Let's pray first before I tell you anything about this week. I'm feeling the anointing. Father, I give you praise. All the glory and all the honor. Oh, I bless your name, Jesus. Because of who you are, I give you glory. Because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, Jesus, I bless your holy name. I worship you. You know that old song, Lord, I worship you because of who you are. Sometimes you become speechless. Sometimes when I start praising, I say, Lord, you're my rock, you're my fortress. You're the Holy One of God. You're the Lamb of glory, the bright, the morning star. The lily of the valley, you're altogether lovely, Jesus. And the Holy Ghost just starts moving upon me. And that love starts to erupt, you know, in your soul. Lord, I pray, visit every person with that new anointing on their life. I pray in the name of Jesus. Visit everyone watching me, Lord, on Periscope and on Facebook. Visit your sweet people, Lord, today with healing power from on high. Lord, if there needs to be change, change them. If there needs to be some rebuilding, rebuild them. Restoration, restore them. Renewal, renew them by the Holy Ghost. Sweet, precious Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus, I pray. And for your honor and glory, Lord, wonderful Jesus. And God's people said, amen. I'm telling you, I feel the anointing. I hope you are too, because I am. I really am. Now listen, sweet people, I want to pray. I really want to pray for the sick right now. I'm feeling something. Oh, my, wonderful Redeemer, wonderful, wonderful Redeemer. I give you praise. Give me a moment. Don't you go away anywhere right now. Don't you leave me right now. I want to turn my music on for just a moment, and I want to pray for the sick. And I want to believe God for a miracle in your life. Wonderful, wonderful Jesus. Wonderful, wonderful Jesus. Jesus, oh, how sweet the name Jesus, every day the same. Jesus, let all saints proclaim worthy praise forever. Thank you, Lord. 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 I love these old hymns. Just lift your hands and receive that healing. In the name of Jesus. Be made whole in his mighty name. For his glory and honor. Right now, I rebuke that sickness in your body. I command that bondage in your life to leave in the name of Jesus, whom I serve. Right now. Right now. Stay with me, precious people. I believe there's people getting healed right now. Be made whole in the name of the Lord Jesus, whom I love and serve right now. Right now. Listen to this. My faith looks up to thee, thou Lamb of Calvary, Savior divine, Just lift your hands and receive your healing. Come on. Now hear me while I pray. Take all my guilt away. Oh, let me from this day be wholly thine. That's what he wants. Surrender right now. Give him even that sickness in your body. Give him that life of yours. Give him that bondage in your soul. He'll set you free. He's a precious Lamb of glory. God, most wondrous. Most wondrous. Jesus is most wondrous. His love, most wondrous story. Someone with a heart condition getting healed right now. I rebuke that condition in the name of Jesus. A skin condition is being healed. I rebuke that. In the name of Jesus. Someone with an ear infection has just been healed. I rebuke that infection in the name of Jesus. Glaucoma, I rebuke it in the name of Jesus. A neck injury, I rebuke that in Jesus' name. Move your neck. The Lord's healing it right now. The Lord is healing someone's neck. Cancer, I command it to go in the name of Jesus right now. Someone's bones are being healed right now. Someone's bones. You know, I began to feel that healing and anointing flowing while I was talking about the Holy Spirit earlier. And that's what the Lord said, pray for the sick right now. I'm healing my people. And I wanted to play these beautiful hymns. Precious Lamb of Glory, we give you praise. Receive your healing in Jesus' name. Receive a fresh touch in Jesus' name. Receive a fresh anointing in Jesus' name. Right now. Wow. Send me your prayer request right now. Pastor Benny at Benny.org. I want to pray over you today. I want to pray over your name. In fact, today, as soon as I get your email, I'm going to pray over your name. Pastor Benny, Benny.org. And I'm going to continue tomorrow, so make sure to join me tomorrow. And Partner Connect begins this week, this coming week. Pastor Connect begins this week. If you want to be a part, you have to go right now online and let me know that you want to be on. And the fee is $20 a month, that's all, to be a part of Partner Connect, Pastor Connect, because I will be training you, equipping you, mentoring you in the things of the Lord. But most important, send me your prayer request so I can pray over your needs. Wow, it's been good. To Jesus be the praise. I'll see you again tomorrow. And don't forget to send that prayer request. Pastor Benny at Benny.org. Jesus, I give you praise for all you're about to do in our lives. And God's people said, amen. I'll see you again. Bye-bye.